So, Janko, your stay in Doha, how's it going?
It's been amazing so far. It's honestly one of the best pre-seasons I ever had. I would like to use this opportunity to thank, first of all, the Smash Tennis Academy for organizing everything for us, Mr. Karim Alami, and especially the Qatar Tennis Association for allowing us to make this amazing preseason here in Doha. I hope the other guys in the group also enjoy it, and we will have more preseasons to come in years to come here.
Janko, you've been here a couple of years ago when you started your career, and do you see any improvements, any changes lately?
It's amazing how much this improved. I was here, I think, 6 or 7 years ago. And, you know, my fellow Serbian Davis Cup teammates are coming here a lot, and they're telling me it's nothing like when you were here 6 or 7 years ago. This is the improvement that I saw in the last 7 years is really, really amazing. You guys can easily have a Masters 1000 event here.
Thank you. Tell us one more thing. What do you want to say to the Qatari youth, you know, the new tennis players coming up? We've got a couple of juniors coming up. The latest one have won some double championships in ITF juniors. What do you want to say to these kind of guys?
Well, first of all, I am really happy that I see a lot of young kids playing, you know, tennis on these courts. You guys have a bunch of courts here, and sometimes we need to fight to get a court, actually, because there are so many young guys playing and practicing. I think it's great, first of all, for the Arabic world that tennis is taking such a big impact, because it's a beautiful sport. And the more kids play, the bigger the chances that one of these guys becomes a true champion or a world number one, who knows.
Take us through your career. I remember you started in those future events in Greece, in many countries, and I remember you started from nothing, and you made it to the top, and now you're a top 10 player.
It wasn't easy, you know. It wasn't all roses and butterflies in the beginning of my career. Sure, I was a successful junior, but the transition to the senior tour, as you said, futures and satellites and challengers, wasn't really pretty. I stayed outside of the top 100 for the first 4 years of my career. Then slowly, I guess I kind of matured, but the big change happened in 2010 when we won Davis Cup. I started prioritizing stuff differently in my life, putting goals where they need to be. And all of a sudden, you know, from 49 I went to number 9, and I am in a beautiful place right now in my mind, and I hope I can stay here for as long as possible.
And the key to your success, is it because you've got your feet on earth, or?
I would say the main reason, apart from, you know, Dirk, my coach, and my team who is traveling with me, apart from the fact that I got married and my wife Biljana is giving me the support in the stability, for me it was always about prioritizing stuff outside of the tennis court. I was always a hard worker. Always when I'm on the court for 2, 3, 4 hours, I give my best. But the problem was that outside of the tennis court, I wasn't doing things in terms of being devoted to tennis 100%. This was the big change, that I understood that the tennis is not only the few hours you spend on court. You need to live and breathe tennis all throughout the week, month, year, and all throughout your career in order to be able to compete with these guys at the top.
One last question. Would you recommend Smash Tennis Academy to your fellows?
I really would, especially because you guys here, at least in this part of the year, have beautiful weather. It's hot, but not too humid. It's dry. And I would really recommend, if somebody wants to do a hardcore preseason, to come to Doha and do it with these guys.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, guys. Thanks.